Throughout this lesson, we've seen that energy differences are the key to understanding reactivity. For instance, we noted that faster reactions occur when there is a small energy difference between the starting materials and transition state. Thus, on the reaction coordinate diagram we're looking at here, we would expect the left-hand reaction to P1 to be favored kinetically. That's because the delta G double dagger, or the activation energy, to get past transition state 1 is smaller than the activation energy required to get past transition state 2. And let's label these delta G double dagger 1 and delta G double dagger 2. We also noted that thermodynamically more stable products tend to be formed in greater amounts. Looking again at P1 and P2, we would expect that P2 is the thermodynamically favored product, because the delta G naught from the starting materials to P2 is more negative than the delta G naught from the starting materials to P1. And let's again label these delta G naught 1 and delta G naught 2. The problem here is that one product is favored kinetically, and the other product is favored thermodynamically. You should immediately have the question, how do we know which factor, kinetics or thermodynamics, is controlling the reaction? And the answer is, it's a function of the reaction conditions, which is nice for us because we can bias the reaction conditions to favor either the kinetic or thermodynamic products if they're different. In this case, they are different, as I've labeled on the reaction coordinate diagram, and the way the distribution of products is most often controlled is to mess with either reaction temperature or reaction time. As you might expect, the kinetic product is favored for short reaction times. This is because at short reaction times, more molecules of starting material will tend to follow the path to the lower energy transition state. Stopping the reaction early gives very few molecules that have reacted to become P1 the chance to get back over TS1 and convert all the way over to the more thermodynamically stable P2. Alternatively, low temperatures will favor the kinetic product because low temperatures offer little energy to P1 to return over TS1 and eventually convert to P2. So the trick to accessing the kinetic product is to use either short times, in which case we trap out the kinetic product, or low temperatures, in which case we trap the product by providing very little energy for P1 to get back over TS1. In other words, we make the reverse reaction from P1 back to the starting material essentially negligible. To favor thermodynamic products, we do the opposite. So at long times or at high temperatures, we favor the thermodynamic product. And the ideas are similar here. At high temperatures, we're providing a great deal of energy to all of the stable species here. So P1, the starting materials, and P2 all have a great deal of energy available to them. As a result, molecules will very easily surmount the transition states in either direction. Thus, starting material molecules that have become P1 are able to revert to the starting material and eventually surmount TS2 to access the more thermodynamically stable product, P2. This overall equilibration over both transition states leads ultimately more so to the more thermodynamically stable product, given enough time. A classic example of a kinetic versus thermodynamic control situation is shown in the Marvin sketch window here. The hydrobromination of dienes can actually form two different products depending on the relative positions of the added H and bromine atoms. If the H and the bromine add in a 1-2 fashion, we form the product you can see here. If the H and the bromine instead add in a 1-4 fashion, then we form the product shown here. This is an issue of thermodynamic versus kinetic control because the top product is favored kinetically. After protonation by HBr, the bromide anion has to travel very little distance to reach the cationic carbon at this position and bond with it. This is why this is the kinetically favored product. However, we can see that the bottom product is thermodynamically favored because the double bond in it is more stable than the terminal double bond of the top product. being more thermodynamically stable, we would expect the bottom product to be the one favored thermodynamically. Thus, at low temperatures, we would expect to favor the product on top, that's the kinetically favored product, and at high temperatures, we would expect to favor the more thermodynamically stable 1,4 hydrobromo compound. If you come up against a situation where different reaction conditions, particularly temperature and time, lead to different products, you know you're dealing with the situation of kinetic versus thermodynamic control. Keep in mind that at low temperatures and short reaction times, kinetic control is operative, while at high temperatures and long reaction times, thermodynamic control is operative.